Hi, I'm Ann Wallace, and I'm the director of the UC San Diego Moores Comprehensive Breast Health Center. And we see about 600 new breast cancer patients a year and work up thousands of women who are either high risk or regular risk. And one of the ways we diagnose breast cancer is through mammography. So I first saw Kim when she presented with a mammogram that was very abnormal and had had a biopsy that showed cancer. And on looking at her mammogram, she had a large area of something that would only be seen on a mammogram. You wouldn't be able to feel it or know about it in any other way.
I'm a retired San Diego City firefighter. I've always been healthy, tried to be active, and try to better my health in any way I could. Earlier this year, I lost my sister to breast cancer. And I decided that I needed to get in and have a mammogram done. They saw some things that they wanted to biopsy, but I just thought it was just another time where they're just going to say everything's okay, but that wasn't the case this time. They found breast cancer.
The American Cancer Society has come out with their new guidelines for screening mammogram for normal risk women. Normal risk meaning no family history, etc. The new guidelines are starting at age 45, a screening mammogram every year, and then at age 54, changing that to every other year.
Since I've been having mammograms, I've been told that I have dense breast, and it's made it hard to feel variations or feel during self-exams, feel if there's new lumps or even if there is a lump. So I could never tell, you know, what I was feeling, if it was a lump or if it was just part of my breast.
So clinical exam is another aspect of the American Cancer Society guidelines that they touched on, and they basically showed that there weren't statistical benefit to having your doctor see and feel your breasts when you go in for your exam. We would like to soften that a little bit and feel that our primary care base is extremely good at picking up breast cancers and knowing the difference between something serious and not. And so we recommend that when you have your primary exam with your doctor, that they do still do a breast exam on you. A woman should know her body the same way she knows her skin, that she knows all the other habits of her body, so that she knows if something different is in her breast, that she can then show it to her doctor.
What I would like to tell other women is that nobody likes to have mammograms. No, they're not fun, but you just have to show up and they do it for you. But it's going to make the difference of early detection. And if you have early detection, it makes a big difference in the rest of your life.
I cannot stress enough the importance of screening mammograms. There is no data that doesn't show clear survival benefit when women get screened. A lot of the controversy that we've heard with changing screening guidelines has been designed to basically figure out who needs to get screened and when they should get screened for overall risk-benefit ratio. But mammograms do save lives, and Kim is a great example of that. Her cancer was only found on mammogram. She didn't feel it, she couldn't see anything, and it detected a very significant breast cancer that saved her life.